Hello, welcome to this video tutorial on how to use Google Meet on video conference. Step 1, you must have your Gmail accounts. If you don't have, then create a new one. Step 2, open your Gmail accounts. Para po sa mga teachers, we have our DepEd Gmail accounts. So, pag nakalagin na kayo, click this 6 dots. Then, find Google Meet icon, this one. So, this is the screen for Google Meet. Then, join or start a meeting. So click. Then this is will pop up. You can put a code or nickname or you can leave it blank. Then click continue. So this is will appear. You have here your microphone and the camera. So before you join a meeting, so click the settings first. Kung gumagana ba yung microphone natin, yung audio at saka yung video. So click this, then pumili kayo kung saan yung naka-active yung microphone. Then, after we set our microphone, try to check our video. So, pag walang lumalabas na picture dito or video, means hindi gumagana yung camera natin. So, click right to check your camera. So, sa akin, ito yung nagamit ko, yung snap camera. Kaya, bumabata ako sa aking camera. Then we can also check the resolution for send and receive resolution. So from 360p, we can change this one to high definition 720p. It means mas maganda yung resolution natin pag nakagamit tayo ng 720p. Then click done. Yan. Now you are ready to join a meeting. You can start your meeting. Yan. So these icons is all about microphone and camera. You can disable this icon. So if you click that icon, the mic will deactivate. As well as your video. If we click again, our microphone is turned on as well as the camera. So bakit merong disable and enable sa ating microphone sa camera? Kasi pag hindi tayo ang nagpre-present, pwede natin i-disable yung microphone para less po yung noise, para yung speaker lang talaga ang magsasalita. Pag ayaw mo naman yung camera mo, then you can click disable. Then magpa-pop up yung icon ng profile nyo sa Gmail. Yan. So, click again. Yan. Balik din yung mic at saka camera natin. Close muna natin. How about this icon? So, pag-click natin tong icon na yan, lalabas po dito yung mga naka-online natin na kasama sa meeting. Then we have chat. So this chat box is visible for everybody. So you can read and you can write through this chat box. So pwede pong hindi kayo magsasalita, naka-turn off yung microphone nyo, pwede kayo makapag-chat dito. Yan. Kung mahihiyain kayo, so just leave a text or just chat. Yan. Enable ko ba yung microphone ko. Then this one, present now. So ang icon na ito ay para po ito sa presenter. Pag may i-present kayo na PowerPoint or video presentation, you just click this present now. Makikita po yung screen ninyo. So try natin. Click your entire screen. Then sa akin, I have two screens din. Click lang yung screen 1. Yan. Have you noticed na wala kayong makikita na picture or camera? So, hindi mo makikita na naka-live ka. So, sila lang yun makikita ng screen mo. So, you can now present your presentation. So, makikita nila yung ginagawa mo sa iyong screen. Yan. So, pagtapos na kayo mag-present, just click this stop presenting. Then, it will return to default settings. So, nakabalik na kayo. Pwede na kayo makapag-chat ba? Chat sa chat box natin. Ensure the people. So, pag gusto nyo i-enable yung camera, just click this screen para makikita nyo itong icons. Yan. Then, how about this 3 dots? So, click nyo yan. Meron po tayo dito record meeting. We can record our meeting. So, pag gusto mo nang i-record, just click that button. So, meron tayong pop-up na message dito. Ask for consent. Recording a meeting without the consent of all participants may be illegal and actionable. You should obtain consent to record this meeting from all participants, including external guests and guests who join late. So, dapat po aware po yung kasama natin sa meeting na recorded po yung meeting natin. So, if you click accept, then it will automatically nagre-record na. So, ito po yung nalabas. Pag naka-read na po yan, it means our video conference is recording. Yan. So, try pa natin itong ibang options. Meron pa tayo itong change layout. So, pag-click natin yan, meron naka-automatically auto yung layout natin. We can try sidebar, title, and spotlight. If this sidebar means makikita nyo to dito yung mga naka-live na ka-video conference natin. Then if you click this layout title, dito lalabas yung mga camera natin yung naka-live. Then, settings. So, we can also adjust our settings here for audio and video. So yan lang po. Meron din po tayong tinatawag na calendar. So dito sa calendar, pwede tayo makapag-create ng meeting. Kung kailan natin gusto mag-meeting, anong date, anong oras, at automatic na mag-send sa email ad ng mga guest na i-add mo. So try natin. Dito sa calendar ko, meron akong nakasit, for example, on May 30, click this one, I have a meeting 3 to 5 p.m. So, pwede mo i-edit yan. So, ito. Type mo lang yung mga guest, mga email ad na gusto mong maka-attend sa meeting na ginagawa mo. Yan. Ito yung date, time, and function. So, if you want to change the time, you just click this one, then drop down. As well as the time range. And then, matatapos na oras. By the way, ito pala yung code for this meeting. So, automatic po makakatanggap ng email yung pinadalhan mo na email ad, yung ina-add mo dito sa guest. So, then, you click save. So, balik tayo sa Google Meet. So, kung mag-chat tayo, click mo lang itong chat box. Then, pwede na kayo makapag-chat. So, yung change yung microphone and camera, you can enable and disable. Just click the screen. So, paano po kung accidentally mawala yung internet connection natin or mag-run out? So, ito lang po yung link na gagamitin nyo. Pag meron kayong link niyan, yung na-receive nyo sa email, for example, na-close ko to, paano balikan? So, open lang sa browser. So, enter. Yan. Yan kasi yung ID para sa conference ng Google Meet natin. Then, click join. So, nakabalik na kayo sa video conference. So, ganyan lang kasimple gamitin si Google Meet. Now, how to in-app our video conference? Diba, naka-record pa tayo dito? So, stop first our recording. Then, stop. So, pag gusto na nating mag-quit or tapos na tayo sa ating video conference, just simply close the Google Meet. Yan, tapos na po yung Google Meet natin. For those guests na gustong mag-join sa Google Meet natin, di ba naka-receive kayo sa emails niyo na how to join the faculty meeting for this one in my email. So, meron tayong nakalagay na join with Google Meet. So, itong link na ito, just copy or click. Automatic, mag-open siya ng new tab sa browser natin. Yan. Then, automatically, join now. So, direct kayo i-login sa inyong Google Meet Conference. Yan nagasimple for those guests or users. So, the same lang sila ng icons na makikita. Meron ding microphone at saka camera. So, you can disable your microphone and video camera. So, you can also click the people icon. So, makikita nyo dito yung mga naka-login. You can also chat on the chat box. You have also your present now then. So, yan po ang makikita for guest. So, paano i-close? Just simply close the tab. Yan. Kung gusto kayong bumalik, just click again the link. Just in case mawala yung internet connection nyo or poor signal or nagbabrun out, you can back your video conference. Then, join now. So, ganyan lang kasimple. So, I hope meron kayong natutunan sa video tutorial na ito. So, thank you.